guess what? July is National Doghouse Repair Month. So we're here to get to the root of our problem and fix our pooch's roof with some plants is Paige.
That's right. Yes, and so it's summertime, but for dogs, this creates a great little place for them. If they're hanging out outside, it's gonna be hot. They're gonna get kind of overheated. This is a cool place for them to chill in. And also, I wasn't just inspired by my own pooches, but I was also inspired by this weekend's premiere of Love Unleashed on Hallmark Channel. Jen Lilly plays the owner of a puppy party service and is trying to find homes for all the shelter dogs. Maybe the puppies will help her find her own forever home along the way. I mean, maybe there's a love story in a Hallmark movie. I'm not sure.
Amazing how many times dogs actually can help their owner, you know, find love.
Oh,
I'm just saying.
They're a love magnet.
They are. That's the whole point.
Yes.
Okay, so this living roof doghouse is going to be great, obviously, for the dogs in there. But you got to tell, let's just kind of rewind and tell everybody why plants. Like, why are we even doing this?
Well, one, it looks really cool. You can see, like, you look out into your yard, you see a doghouse, not so cute. This looks really good. So it takes away that eyesore of a doghouse. But let's talk about practicality of it. It actually, in the summertime is going to keep your puppy cool. It insulates.
Interesting. So in order to create this, living roof, is you got to have like a box. You've got to have something to hold it all together.
Exactly.
Right?
So the first thing you want to do is make sure that you measure the sides of your roof. Now, I have a dual pitched roof. So I measured once for both sides. It's going to be equal. But you can also do this on a one pitch roof or on a flat roof. Because we're doing it with succulents. You don't need a lot of water.
Good.
So you can do it on any kind of roof that you have.
Great.
So we measured that out. And you can see I added a little 1x4 all the way around to the sides. If you don't have a pitched roof, this part's going to be even easier because you don't need to. Oh, thank you.
Yep.
Because you don't need to cut at an angle. But this was just a normal 45 degree.
And really, there's only, well, there's four cuts, but there's only one side that you're cutting the 45 on, so you can't really go wrong. Okay, good.
Pull this out. Okay. You want to reinforce with wood glue. If you had a lot of time to just sit and hold it or put clamps on it, you could actually, I'm going to put that out there. You could just do it with glue. You could also do it with screws. I'm using a nail gun because why not? We've got one here.
And they're fun to use.
They are fun to use. And because of my doghouse, you can do this on any kind of doghouse that you have. Because my doghouse was a little flimsy on the wood inside, I wanted to make sure I didn't split it.
Okay.
So I'm using nails. That'll be the smallest way to take care of it. And
you don't need anybody to hold that one.
No, you just stay back there. Just enjoy.
I'll take care of everything back here, which
so
is not much.
One on the inside, and then you're going to want to go all the way along the bottom.
Great.
But again, pay attention to what you have on your own doghouse.
And I'll notice as you're finishing that up, I want to show everybody. Actually, I guess I got to wait for you to finish. I'm going to tilt this. Will you tell everybody? I love how you went a little bit longer on the side pieces to create a drainage area.
Exactly. I just did a little, maybe a quarter of an inch bigger, because if you do have any draining, it would be nice to kind of come off the side so it's not stuck on the roof. You want to create a waterproof roof anyway.
Yeah.
But to give it that little extra draining would be great. If you did it right up to the thing, you could also punch some holes in it, drill some holes in it that would work as drainage. But you know what? If you're building it from scratch, I say just leave it there with the gap.
Okay, fantastic.
Okay,
so we've got our walls all set. We've got our drainage set. Now we're going to put a little felt in the bottom.
This is called roofing felt.
Okay.
And let's put it on and over. This is actually used on regular homes. Thank you so much. I'm adding this just to the sides here because we want to make sure that the middle of it stays dry. So I'm going to go all the way down. This can be found in your local hardware store. You want to do that one?
Sure.
But let me tell you why it's so wonderful. Because it is algae resistant, it stands up to the cold and ice, extreme heat, it's water resistant. I mean, pretty much anything that's going to be dangerous to your dog, it's resistant to it.
Listen, it's going to make the whole thing last even longer, so fantastic.
Mildew resistant, I mean, just keep naming things, it'll be resistant.
Now, the interesting thing is, one of the things that I thought of when I first saw this is, man, aren't these going to slide down, and how are they going to hold their place?
And I will tell you, I tried without it.
Okay.
It did slide a little.
Gotcha.
So we decided to add some chicken wire.
Very smart.
And you don't need to go all the way to the ends. Will you grab that stapler again?
Yes.
And just kind of go in between there.
You got it.
What this really helped for was to kind of hold the roots of these. And using succulents, they kind of come apart anyway. Thank you. I'll just put this. But if you want to use bigger ones, I had a little cheat for that too. Because look how cool this is. This creates like a tiny little hole. And let me grab some of the smaller succulents.
Got it.
So you buy them. Some of them come like this, that they're this tiny. And you go ahead and just put them right in there. The soil will fall. And then you can add additional soil around it.
Of course.
Make sure you give it a little spritz.
That's all it needs initially, isn't it?
It is, yes. Wow. Okay.
And now, what about for the bigger succulents?
For the bigger ones, I took a little wire cutter, and I just cut a bigger hole in here.
Okay.
So, and then pulled it back, and this will fit the roots, so you don't have to cut them out. And then you kind of like open it up just a little bit.
Not sure which one you want to use.
I'll use this one.
That guy right there, okay.
This is good. Very good. And while you're putting it into, you can get a little bit out. You're going to have some cleanup after this.
Yeah, for sure.
And then you want to make sure that the roots are still intact there. And because they're succulents, they will fall apart like that. Just stick it in a different part of the chicken wire.
That's one of the beautiful things about succulents is that if part breaks off, you can just stick it in the ground
yes.
and it'll start growing a new plant.
Yeah, don't even worry about it. Yep.
It's amazing. Oh, so great. And then like you say, you kind of add in the extra dirt, pack it in there,
yep.
and then you'll end up with something as beautiful as this.
And while I was doing this, one thing that I found at the hardware store in their garden section was stuff that was already stuck together like this. This comes in an entire sheet.
Okay.
And it's only about $15. And that comes already planted for you. So you can kind of see around the edges.
Yeah.
I used a lot of that.
Here and here, yeah.
Almost like as a little cheat to do the outside so it would be filled in. And another thing I want to mention, just when I looked down here, when I looked at the plants, I saw the little staples. You want to make sure that the size of your staples, the size of your staples do not go through and can attack the dog on the other side. You want to make sure that it is small enough and you can kind of see those are 1/4 inch. So we're making sure that we're not going through the roof of our doghouse.
Which would defeat the whole purpose of rain and everything that was coming through the doghouse.
Yeah, because if you're going to scratch them in there, I mean, they'd rather have rain.
I think it's a fantastic idea and very well executed. Thank you so much, Paige. Full instructions, visit hallmarkchannel.com and be sure to catch Love Unleashed this Saturday at 9, 8 central right here on Hallmark Channel. And I know.